Good evening. I'm Ann Trujillo.
And I'm Shannon Ogden. That mother is talking exclusively tonight with Denver 7's Jackie Crea.
And Jackie, she's now threatening to sue so she can get some answers.
Well, the most important thing tonight is 8-year-old Alina Hernandez is okay. She felt some side effects, but it's what could have happened that has her mom worried for the other students at Central Elementary in Commerce City.
What grade are you in?
Second.
Monique Marquez and her 8-year-old daughter, Alina, have come a long way. Alina has epilepsy.
She'll have full-blown ones where she shakes, her eyes roll black. She'll have one where she just kind of stares off.
At its worst, she was seizing 40 times a day. Now, they are few and far between as long as she has her medication, Benzel. Every morning, the nurse at Central Elementary gives Alina her first dose. But this time, something went wrong.
They called me around 10:30, letting me know that my daughter was complaining that she wasn't feeling good, and that they're pretty sure that the nurse, the sub-nurse, gave my daughter somebody else's medication.
The substitute nurse, she says, not the usual nurse, gave her the wrong seizure medication. Alina was rushed to the ER. Monique met her there.
Slurring her words like she was just like, kind of like gone, you know, like she was talking to me, but it was like really slow.
Alina is okay, but now Monique wants answers and says the district is giving her the runaround.
It could be worse. My child could have died. What if it was a different medication? You know, so I just want it to be out there and people to know.
The family is considering a lawsuit and have hired an attorney.
What steps they're going to actually take to ensure that her daughter is going to be safe going forward?
I feel like I really wasn't even going to take it this far. I just wanted answers. I wanted to either press charges against her. I wanted her name. I just wanted to know what's going to happen to this lady. Is she getting fired? Is she able to serve medications again? Is this going to happen to another child?
We reached out to the Adams 14 school district, but because this is now a legal matter, they could not comment. Now, Monique did say the district had apologized, but at this point, she has no idea if that nurse is still with the district. We promise we'll stay on top of this for you. I'm live in the studio. Jackie Crea, Denver 7.
Thank you, Jackie.